from there, I trained there for like 2 or 3 years. That really instilled a big, big, it really made a dent, and not a dent, but it really defined my identity around that time tremendously, just because of the nature of the training.
Gotcha.
And just the people there and their spiritual base. It really made an impact on my life as a black man specifically.
Okay.
You know, just seeing that type of structure and power and, you know, honor and respect with other black men in my community, that was revolutionary for me to see, you know. And I won't get too far into, like, the spiritual side of that, but because that's in the past. But I really want to say that, you know, it's called Top 10 Karate Studio.
Okay.
Always shout out to everybody there, Sensei Deshaun, Sensei Rogers, everybody there. I always have respect for it.
Wonderful.
But that was in high school, and I'm 23 now, so the journey continues on to college, and, you know, I really wanted to compete more because I never really got to compete much there, so I went into Taekwondo. I did that for a little bit, got a yellow belt, almost got a blue belt. Taekwondo wasn't really it. I didn't really like all the kicks and stuff.
Okay.
From there, I started doing a whole, this is when I really, when in college, the thing about college is there's so many different martial arts clubs that there's like a smorgasbord of options. So I tried everything. I tried boxing, Muay Thai again, like I said, Taekwondo. That's when I started getting into Shotokan myself.
Okay.
Which I now hold a fourth Q in. And then one of my favorites is Capoeira. That's in college I found Capoeira, and that's honestly when my martial arts journey changed again tremendously.
Okay.
And I feel like I'm still kind of on that tip right now because Capoeira has been a part of my life for the last 4 years. It's the martial art I can honestly say I've trained the longest in. So.
Okay. All right.
And I graduated, and now I'm going back into MMA, still doing Capoeira, and karate is like an on and off thing again. That's about my journey, the abridged version at least.
It is indeed a journey, and when you said MMA is the ultimate form of putting your own style of martial arts together, which in like Bruce Lee advised, you know, taking the best out of every individual art form and putting it together to create your own, which he did with jiu-jitsu. Obviously, I think you're right on point with that as far as MMA is concerned. MMA is the ultimate, for those who don't understand or don't know, MMA is mixed martial arts. MMA is the ultimate form of, you know, a combination of different art forms that people put together, you know, to get in this open combat where there's no particular style. It's what your combination of style, style and form is that you bring to the to your competition. Some folks are, you know, more astute at boxing. Some folks are more in grapples and holds, aikido, judo, etc., etc. So it's really, like you say, a smorgasbord of different forms that one can put together. I guess whoever is able to put the best forms together that that can overcome any other out there is the ultimate champion at the end of the day.
And I think even on top of that is more so who can put together the best style for themselves.
Because yes.
One thing I always found a limitation of martial arts is there's no one size fit all
right
for everybody. And especially when I came into my identity as an African man, like, you know, my African identity aside from my American black identity, and really started learning about the philosophies of the continent and the different people on there, I realized that it's only fitting that I find the martial art and take the best things out of that martial art to fit me as an individual, because I feel like personally, you know, me as an African, I don't, my philosophy is I don't believe that that everything is polarized, that there's separation in everything. I feel like everything is connected, but everything has a context, you know, everything has a place for it. And I feel like living in the West, everything is so compartmentalized, everything is so separate, it's like almost like you can't do one thing and have the other, and that doesn't really make sense. And I think Bruce Lee also had that same philosophy, and that's why he was so revolutionary.
Gotcha. Yeah, yeah. You're definitely an admirer of Bruce Lee, just like I am. He's definitely an idol for me as well. I believe in his philosophies and then of course what he was able to attain, and I also believe in the way he was able to coin and put things together in his own way. Like he said, he was revolutionary. You talked about your African identity. Definitely, that's not something I wanted to touch on, because obviously you were able to trace your roots to Africa, to two particular countries. Can you say a little? Can you talk a little bit about that?
So back in 2017, at my college, I was a part of this club called Sankofa, and they had a contest where you can win an African ancestry DNA test. So I had heard about African ancestry from a while ago, but it was really, really expensive around that time, so I didn't think I was ever going to be able to take it anytime soon because I was a broke college student. So okay. When that came around, I was really excited. So that was when I took my maternal test. And the maternal test traces your mitochondrial DNA, which never, ever changes for the most part in your whole lineage. And it's passed down from mother to child. Okay. So when it comes down to the first woman in my family, it was a Themne Fula woman from Sierra Leone and Guinea-Bissau.
Okay.
So that's what my DNA test showed. And I recently took my pilgrimage back home to Themne land and Sierra Leone, Koya, and reamalgamated myself with that culture specifically.
Okay.
And it was a great experience because I feel like every African American, every Black American, whatever you want to call yourself, in the West, every African diasporan is sort of looking for that reconnection, that Sankofa, to reach back and grab what they lost. And I'm glad I was able to do that in that context.
Okay.
And I took my father's test when I got a job. I got money. I took the other one, which is my father's one. They test the Y DNA chromosome, and that came back to the Balanta people of Guinea-Bissau.
Guinea-Bissau.
So those people, specifically both the Themne and the Balanta, are known for the prestige of not only just their character, but also on the battlefield. Very independent, strong-willed, and very honorable people. But especially the Balanta, I've been researching a lot, and they actually have martial arts embedded in their culture.
Okay.
And that really stood out to me because obviously I'm a martial artist. I love it. And when I found that, I found other similarities with other cultures that they have martial arts built into their almost like their
tradition.
Own everyday life.
Right.
Yeah, the tradition, exactly.
Mm-hmm.
The Balanta people are really big wrestlers.
Okay.
So, and that's along that whole coast up into Senegal and Gambia as well.
Okay.
I don't know if you've ever heard of lamb wrestling.
Right, right.
It's the same thing. It's
yes.
not just clustered in Gambia. It's not just clustered in Senegal. It's all over that
all
region.
Over. Yes.
So
yes.
When I go there next year, I plan to train that a little bit. And hopefully my goal when it comes as a martial artist now, I'm not just searching for different, you know, Eurasian martial arts to get into and become initiated in, like, you know, karate, MMA, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, all of that. All of that's good. I'm going to train those and take what I can from those.
Mm-hmm.
But when it comes to me being fulfilled personally as a martial artist, I won't be completely satisfied until I reconnect with my African martial traditions, or I should say Mansu traditions, because that was the original name for martial arts, is Mansu arts.
Gotcha.
It comes from the Egyptian god of war instead of the Roman god of war, Mars. It comes from Mantu.
Okay.
So, yeah. So
you've done your research there. That's awesome.
Yeah,
that's really nice to
know. I'm a warrior scholar.
Yes.
I'm a scholar in a warrior.
Yes, indeed. And I love that you could trace it back to Africa instead of Rome. Because everything that we talk about here, obviously we know these things that we're talking about originated, like we say, from Africa initially.
Exactly.
Everything has been either kind of watered down or lost in translation over time, but we know a lot of these things originated from Africa. And obviously, you talked about the wrestling. Wrestling is big across Africa, Black Africa. I would say Black Africa, because Africa is all black, you know. Anyway, I don't know why I'm even saying that, you know. Yeah, so it kind of defeats the purpose, you know. But the martial arts is definitely. The art form of fighting, yes, definitely is prevalent across Africa. So you didn't lose your identity in so many ways. Your ancestry through your DNA was able to tell you that who you are, what you are, and why you still love the martial arts the way you are, because it's in your DNA. It's in you. Exactly. It's part of you. You know, so. Your journey has come full circle. Your journey has come full circle with you being able to trace and connect back with your ancestry, and then obviously with your passion in the fighting form in the martial arts. Look, Jordan, this is a conversation we definitely will continue with at some later stage. We'll look at other aspects of. Your life as you evolve into this mixed martial artist out there, but for today, you know, I would love to thank you and for coming on and giving us an idea into who you are and your connection to, you know, the African continent. Obviously, you are an African, just like every other black person out there in the diaspora. You know, even any other human being out there, let's just be plain about that. Yes, you know, whether they want to admit it or not, you know, exactly. So I thank you for coming on, and yes, you're very welcome, and definitely look forward to having another chat with you at some later date.
Yeah, definitely. Hopefully in the future. With the way my research is going now, I'm gonna keep a lot more.
That is awesome. That'll be wonderful, because obviously there'll be a great conversation, a great revelation to our audience out there who listen to us on a weekly basis, and definitely some, you know, a lot of people would love to know more about that, including you know, Africans who were born, you know, on in recent time on the continent that don't really know the history of those things. They've been lost to over time because of lack of archival information in history and things like that. But thank you anyway, and we'll definitely revisit that, and we'll talk some more when you come back from your research, and after doing your research into these art forms, and then we'll have something nice and great to reveal to our audience out there.
Yeah, I look forward to it.
Definitely.
Don't think the same as everyone else. It's your call. There are no rules. See, you'll never conclude with anyone else. Don't think the same as everyone else. If I had everything, everything, I could change anything, I could change anything. If I changed anything, I mean anything, I would change everything, oh yeah.
When the media slings mud, we use it to build huts. Irrefutable facts, merciful, beautiful, black, beloved brother, you fail to embarrass them, harassing them. To my life, your life pales in comparison. So go write whatever blog. Messiness is not ever the God. Do what's necessary, I'm never worried. Listen, vultures, I've been shackled by Western culture. You convinced most of my people to live off emotion. That's why we competing. Death by the chrome barrel, forgot the secrets. My killer been Jared, bone marrow's the deepest. You can peep at the comments, but don't fall for that. We want freedom. I'm a scholar in almanac. people do anything to be involved in everything. Inclusion is a hell of a drug. Some people have everything they probably ever wanted in life and never have enough.
I had everything.